Friends, today we are going to learn about preparation of profit and loss account. In last part, we discussed preparation of trading account. Now I am going to solve one problem. This question taken from Tamil Nadu government 11th standard textbook. Look at the board.
Yes.
From the following detail, prepare profit and loss account for the year ended 31st December 2017. First item is gross profit. Gross profit recorded in the credit side of profit and loss account. Credit side of profit and loss account, the value 21,05,000 rupees. Next, a very important item is given, that is called trade expenses. When trade expenses are given, you have to read the entire problem. You have to check whether office expenses are given or not. So trade expenses are given. Otherwise, no office expenses are given. So, trade expenses given without office expenses. So, it should be debited to the profit and loss account. Trade expenses value 20,000. In this problem, trade expenses alone given. So, it should be debited to the profit and loss account. Sometime, trade expenses and office expenses are given. In that case, the trade expenses debited to the trading account.
Yes.
Next, carriage on sales. So profit and loss account debit to carriage on sales. Carriage on sales, the value 1,00,000 rupees. Next, office salary, it is debited to the profit and loss account. Office salaries 2,38,000. Next we have postage. Postage is office expenses, indirect expenses. Postage, the value 2,200. Next, legal expenses, profit and loss account debit. Legal expenses, the value 4,000 rupees. Next, audit fee, profit and loss account debit. Profit and loss account debit, value 16,000. Next, donation given, that is also debited to the profit and loss account. Donation given, value 11,000 rupees. Next, sundry expenses. Sundry expenses or miscellaneous expenses or general expenses debited to the profit and loss account. Sundry expenses, value 3,600. Next, discount allowed is an expense debited to the profit and loss account. Discount allowed, value 30,000 rupees. Next, office lighting, profit and loss account debit. Office lighting, profit and loss account debit, value 19,800. Next, commission received, it is an income. It is an income credited to the profit and loss account. Value 14,400. Then interest on loan, it is an expense. Profit and loss account debit. Interest on loan is an expense. Profit and loss account debit 22,000. Next, stationery. Stationery is office expenses. Profit and loss account debit. Value 14,000. Next, export duty on sales, it is office expenses. Export duty on sales, when we import goods from other country, we supposed to pay import duty, that is debited to the trading account. When we sell goods to some country, we have to pay export duty, that expenses related to sales debited to the profit and loss account. Next, miscellaneous or other income, profit and loss account credit. Miscellaneous receipt 5,000 rupees. Next, traveling expenses related to the sales. Two, traveling expenses debited to the profit and loss account. Value 66,000. Next, selling expenses, profit and loss account debit. Selling expenses 53,200. Now I'm going to balance this. In this problem, credit total heavier than debit total. So credit total, already I totaled 21,24,400. Deduct all debit side expenses, we'll get one value that we called net profit. For net profit, we should not write CDBD. The net profit transferred to capital account. Net profit should be transferred to the capital account. The value already I ascertained 15,01,600. Students, we are preparing profit and loss account. In profit and loss account credit side, first item is gross profit. If given, if gross loss is given, it should be debited. Then profit and loss account debit side, all indirect expenses. Indirect expenses, what is indirect expenses? Indirect expenses incurred to run the office for sale of goods, called indirect expenses. Indirect expenses are office administration, selling, distribution and financial expenses. So in profit and loss account debit side, all indirect expenses are recorded, which are office expenses, administration expenses, selling expenses, distribution expenses and financial expenses. In this problem, credit side total heavier than debit side total. I totaled first the credit side, then I brought to the debit side, then I deducted all debit expenses. I got one value called a net profit. Sometime the debit value may be more than the credit side, that time we'll get a loss. The net profit should be added with the capital. Students, we completed preparation of profit and loss account. In next class, we'll learn balance sheet. Till then, bye and thank you.